Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM. Anytime you hear this tune, of course, you know, we're back on the block to talk about surveying and also advocate for the best practices in that profession so that we can get it right as it relates to the physical and the urban space of Nigeria. You're welcome to The Benchmark. This great Friday morning. Today is the 10th of May, the year 2024. All right. This installment of The Benchmark will be exploring the relevance of surveying in today's world. The questions are being asked as to where we can fit them into and the roles that they contribute in the development of the society. So we'll be talking about that in detail. But quickly, taking you through the roads, we've talked about the impediment earlier on, somewhere around the Lekki-Ajah corridor, precisely by Jakonde intersection in what's Lekki. I understand we had a minor accident earlier on. It's a loaded tipper with a battery and a gear problem, which was occupying 50% of the road at that time on the main carriageway. But the good news, it has been taken off, so it's a much better drive navigating through that corridor right now. Those of you making use of the Third Milan Bridge, the road to that end is still looking good. Awotola and others, you can keep me posted on that impediment that connects Nurudin Olu Opopo. We had that earlier on. I hope it has been taken out. It was a broken down truck laden with 40 feet container. So let's see if that is off the road right now. You can keep me posted on that one as well. Let me see if you can just run through. Apapa Oshodi Expressway earlier on too. We talk about five star in what Oshodi, where we had multiple accident involving a Kia Salon. Okay, that's a salon car. And of course, we also had another Mack truck too that was involved in that accident. But you can keep me posted what's happening with those impediments at this time. Let's hope that that has been taken off right now. The benchmark on Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM. Today, we are exploring the relevance of surveying in today's world. And joining me in the studios this morning, I've got Surveyor Agwu Ogonna Roberts. He's a member, Nigerian Institution of Surveying, and of course, the Publicity Secretary of APPSN Lagos State Branch. Surveyor Agwu Roberts, nice to have you back in the studios. Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Victor. It's good to be back here.
And how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good.
All right. He's been joined on the program by Surveyor Komolafe Abimbola, who's also a member, Nigerian Institution of Surveying. He's the Publicity Secretary of that institution, by the way. Institution of Surveyors, that's what they are called, actually, Lagos State Branch. Surveyor Komolafe Abimbola, rather. Nice to have you in the studios. Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
And how are you doing?
I'm fine. I'm very good.
All right. So, Surveyor Agwu Roberts, yesterday was a big day at the Nigerian Institution of Surveyors. What were you guys doing at that particular outing yesterday?
Okay, so yesterday was a very big day in the institution. Generally, we had the investiture of fellows. 14 fellows were invested yesterday. Yes.
And that speaks a whole lot of volume, right?
Yes, it does.
So in terms of significance of that particular one, when you are investing or perhaps you are doing an investiture for this number of fellows in the industry, how does that speak to the development of the profession?
Okay, yes. It does speak volumes because for you to be invested, pronounced a fellow and admitted into fellowship, into that fellowship cadre of the Nigerian Institution of Surveyors, it tells that you have paid your dues, you have contributed immensely to the development of the institution by way of helping to promote the good standards for which surveyors are known for.
Right. So we have 14 new inductees,
yes,
so to say.
14 new fellows.
And so the ranks of the fellows will be swelling right now.
Yes, it does. It should be in the neighborhood of 400 and about 440, something or thereabouts.
Fellows?
Yes.
Across Nigeria?
Yes.
When we look at the number of surveyors that we have in the country, even dead and alive as it stands today, what does the figure speak to?
Okay, we have dead and alive, we have about 5,800 and... 5,865.
Yes. Wow. With to a ratio of 200 million people?
200 plus million Nigerians, yes.
So does that speak volume to the fact that the profession is really, really challenged in terms of man capacity?
Well, we are still being underutilized, even though the number is low compared to the needs that we are supposed to be meeting. But even at that, we are still being underutilized.
So, Abimbola, let me bring you in at this point. So, we are trying to see and try to answer the relevance question for surveyors. Talk to my listeners out there. If you have to identify who the surveyor is, the roles that they play, can you just run us through that?
Okay, thank you. A surveyor is someone who has fulfilled all criteria in serving KEDA, and as well, he is registered under the Second Act of CAPS S18 Law of the Federation of Nigeria 2004.
Okay.
And surveyors are relevant in all fields of works.
All fields?
Yes.
Why do you say that?
Because generally, survey practice speaks more of positioning, where you are, what you do at a particular time. So when we talk about where you are, what you are, and positioning, it speaks volume, and that is what serving profession is all about.
All right. Now, even on this program, your colleagues have been able to identify the fact that surveying is the bedrock, perhaps the foundation of all meaningful development. And I always want to emphasize that you guys do say that meaningful development in any society. Agwu, for someone who might not really understand what that means, I need to break it down for our listeners this morning. When you say surveying is perhaps the foundation or perhaps the bedrock of all meaningful development, how do you break it down to the understanding of that person so he knows what we're talking about?
Okay, so I would like to add another word to that. I would like to say that surveying is the bedrock for all meaningful and sustainable development.
Sustainable?
Yes.
Okay, that should be added.
Yes, and that means that sustainable development simply means the ability of the present generation to meet their needs without impairing or without impeding the ability of the future generations to also meet their needs. So you're developing with the future generation in mind.
Right.
Yes.
So where does it all start from?
It starts from location. Okay. What is where? Where is what? What is where? Where is what?
So let's dissect that now. So what is where?
Okay. So what is where talks about what do you have at a particular location?
And at a particular time.
At a particular time.
Okay. So that's a common parlance for you, surveyors.
Yes.
Because I can see the way surveyor Abimbola is also echoing what you're saying. So what is where means what you have at a particular space,
yes,
at a particular time.
Yes.
And where is what?
Yes. Where is what? So this particular feature, how do we locate it? It is the surveyor that tells you. We have one of our slogans is the surveyor knows, you can't hide from a surveyor. He knows places you can never tell.
You mean it?
Yes. So the surveyor is vast with knowledge of locations.
Okay, so if that's the case, I mean, other professionals too, we also lay the same claim. Geologists will also tell you, well, I can hide something for you within the rocks and underneath this location or that place.
Well, with all due respect to our geologists, because we are allied colleagues, with all due respect to them, they know what exists, but the surveyor will tell them accurately where that thing exists.
Yes. So that's the difference.
That's the difference.
So you can spot where is, where and what is at every point in time.
Yes, so they will now be the ones to now interpret, okay, this thing you have found, this is what it is. But we will tell you where exactly that thing is.
Right. So Abimbola, a lot of times people seem to misconstrue that concept, and they feel what we know the surveyors for are just, you know, to do the survey plan. What would you say to those who have that kind of feeling?
All right. As we all know that surveying in recent times combines technology and geography to accurately establish positions of natural and cultural futures as he has rightly said, near, inside, and on the surface of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
So when we talk about surveying in the aspect of how it is applied in other sense, we talk about it in solving so many problems. Solving so many problems that we face presently,
mm-hmm.
and as well, in all built industries, we see that surveying is important and very, very relevant.
So that is it. So, and that's where I want to come in. We know that you are very relevant, but people seem to limit what you do to just a survey plan. So what will you say to those kind of people?
Okay. When we talk about surveying, we talk about so many applications in surveying. We do more than that.
Okay. It's not just a survey plan.
No. We have what we call engineering, construction, we and maintenance, like what they did on Todd Millan Bridge.
Mm-hmm.
You see surveyors there. We are relevant.
So there's no way that job would have been carried out without the surveyors. Is that what you're saying now?
Yes, because it's at a particular location.
Okay.
And all is at a particular point.
Hmm.
All the constructions, whatsoever it is at a particular point and at a particular time.
All right, so let's give another scenario in a survey, Agwu Robert. So, per adventure, the third Milan Bridge was to be upgraded and was to have another bridge on top of that bridge, or perhaps two other layers of bridges ahead of that bridge. Will a surveyor be needed?
Definitely. If you decide to put up another carriageway, either side by side the existing carriageway we have, or you decide to install another layer above what we have, it mm-hmm. is a surveyor that will give you the precise position. Okay. It's a surveyor that would help you set out the precise position. Let me just give a scenario. Imagine the Lagos-Calabar Coastal Highway.
Yeah.
Imagine that construction work is to start from both ends simultaneously, and then you're starting work from the Lagos end and the Calabar end. If you don't bring surveyors on board at every stage of the project, one thing will likely happen. If the two works are supposed to meet at, say, maybe Edo State, it's very likely that the one coming from Calabar end would have turned into Kogi State, and the one coming from Lagos end would have turned into Delta State.
Mm.
So it is a surveyor that ensures that at every point in time, your construction work is kept on the designed alignment. So looking at the works of the Third Mainland Bridge, which we are all familiar with in Lagos,
right?
One of the things that one integral part of every project is costing, volume calculation and costing. And one of the things that surveyors do in those kind of projects is to help provide the parameters with which the cost engineers will determine the cost that is required to finish that project.
So invariably, nothing will go as per that construction without a surveyor. That's what you're saying now.
Yes.
All right, let's take that to another level. So general practice for surveying, how do we break that down for our listeners? What are the general practice?
Okay, so we, like my colleague rightly said, we have various aspects of surveying. So there's the engineering surveying, there's hydrographic surveying, which has to do with surveying activities on water bodies. Then we have remote sensing and photogrammetry. So that has to do with surveying from the space or area. Onboard airborne vessels where you have planes that are used to fly, you know, over territories. But with the advent of technology, we now achieve that using drone technology.
Okay.
So you can fly a drone over a particular place to map that region. And then the surveyors are now trained to carry out analysis on the products of those drone shots, you know. So you have cadastral surveying, which is what we are all used to.
Mm-hmm.
The end product of the cadastral survey is the plans on blue papers, which we are all used to. So a lot of people have limited the profession of surveying mm-hmm. to just those plans.
Exactly.
But that is just a minute fraction of what surveyors do.
Right. So let's look at other areas now. I remember on this program we've talked about the fact that if you live in a multi-story kind of building,
yes.
there are different kinds of surveys that can be carried out for that building. Is
yes.
that correct?
Yes.
Right. Strata survey is one of them.
Yes.
Talk to me. What is strata survey?
Okay, so strata survey is a it's a type of cadastral survey that helps in procurement of title for apartments or multi-level structures. So, for instance, if you have a 10-story building and you have various subscribers on each of the floors of that part of that building, everybody is expected to have his own individual survey plan. So your survey plan is supposed to be, survey plan of the person on the first floor is supposed to be independent of the survey plan of the person on the second floor. It's supposed to be different, rather.
Why is that so? I mean, people are thinking that once there's a survey plan for that land, why do I still need another survey plan for the apartment?
Okay, so if the person on the first floor decides to get a bank facility with his apartment, the bank will request for documents that show ownership to his own apartment. But if all they have is just the global survey and the global COO that covers the entire property, that means the person on the first floor can take that document to the bank, and whatever collateral he has used that property to get a facility from the bank now covers everybody who owns property there. But the bank will request for a title that ties a particular unit or a particular apartment of that property to that person. So it is advisable that if you live on multi-level structures like that, you should have your own title. So the global survey plan and the global COO serves as the root of title for which you derive your own individual title.
And then who carries that out for me? Who's going to do that for me?
Yes, of course, the surveyor does your strata surveys.
Okay. Any of the surveyors, any of the private surveyors can do that?
Yes, any private surveyor, any private practicing surveyor can do that.
Right. Lagos Traffic Radio, 96.1 FM, Obolaji Bank, Anthony, and Ikeja Corridor. We can tell you the update there says that we have slow moving traffic from Leventis proceeding towards Nightel intersection. This is as a result of a total filling station dispensing fuel, but we have a queue. For motorists, then another queue for those who are navigating through that corridor. Aside from that, other areas within the axis is still looking very, very good. Traffic managers on ground doing the needful in all those places. All right, so let's explore other areas of relevance now for surveyors generally. All right, you mentioned some of the things that they can be called for. What other aspects can one get will one need the services of a surveyor, Surveyor Abimbola?
Yeah, thank you. As I said rightly, that survey application is into several fields. One of the fields we just mentioned is construction.
Okay.
Going further, we are relevant in agricultural production and processing.
You mean it too?
Yes.
In the farms?
Yes.
Why do I need a surveyor there?
You know, farming, agriculture has gone beyond just planting rice and beans. You know, agriculture, we have GIS, Geographic Information System applications in farm management, whereby the farm managers these days don't necessarily go to the farm. From the comfort of their offices, they can administer a farm. So you need to know what is planted at every particular point. You know, for instance, if you come to a palm plantation,
right,
you need to know how many trees you have. You need to know the location of every one of those trees. So, for instance, if you now have a diseased tree, you should know how to identify that tree and then set out a buffer zone and then know the other trees and how many trees are at risk of infection.
So, in agric, surveyors can also play a role too?
Yes, a vital role.
Beyond that profession, which other profession can one find the job of a surveyor?
Yeah, you can as well find surveyors very relevant in military intelligence and strategies, infrastructural development, estate management, population head count, tax assessment.
You mean it?
Yes.
These are areas of revolution for me, you know. Population, what do you call it now?
Yes, population head count. Yes.
Head count.
Yes.
During census, surveyors are needed.
Definitely.
It's not just to count people. Why do we need a surveyor?
You know, before the actual counting happens, there's what is called the enumeration area demarcation.
That's right.
Yes, which is where the country is delineated into states and then smaller pockets of, you know, settlements. It is a surveyor that will map out these territories.
Ooh.
Do a count, analyze the data you have by way of houses. How many settlements do we have? How many houses do we have? and all that. Because census goes beyond just knowing the number of people. It helps the government to plan adequately on structures and infrastructure to be put in place to meet the growing population.
So very correct. Surveyors
play a very important role in this.
Wow. I'm just seeing the connection now, you know. Before now, I've hosted the National Commissioner representing Lagos, who, you know, did articulate most of the things that you just said right now, the area demarcation, the elimination area demarcation areas, and how it all works. So never in my mind did I connect it with surveyors who can also play a part in that regard. All right, so which is good. So population census, what else? What other areas did you say can be needed?
Okay. Other areas, surveyors are very vital and important, and they play key roles. Healthcare delivery, forestry, telecommunications, navigations, as well as transportation.
The same transport that we're doing right now.
Exactly.
Definitely.
You mean it? You guys need to be everywhere.
Let's
talk about healthcare, first of all. So, what is the connection between a surveyor and healthcare?
Okay, so every state, for instance, let's look at the state. Now, you know, we have the primary healthcare, secondary healthcare, and tertiary healthcare institutions in every state. Now, the state minister of health should know the spread of their hospitals.
Oh.
Yes. You don't just cite hospitals because your people need a hospital. There should be, in surveying, there's what we call triangulation. Now, triangulation is where you have network of points, and then you now do a kind of like in layman's terms, throw lines to connect those points. Now, if you triangulate hospital networks we have in the state,
mm-hmm.
you will be able to tell by the population distribution and demography of every particular location, you'll be able to tell, do a simple analysis, if the hospitals you have in every community are enough.
Wow.
Yes. So, and you're going to do this effectively, you will need maps. You need to have precise location of all your hospitals in a state. So if you look at Ikeja, for instance,
mm-hmm.
you need to know the areas of Ikeja that are densely populated. You need to know the demographics of those particular areas. You now need to bring it down to how many healthcare facilities do we have in Ikeja?
Mm.
Is it adequate to cater for the needs of the people? Now, there should be accessibility between the primary, secondary, and tertiary healthcare. So if we have an issue in, for instance, the health centers, how do we get to the next hospital that should handle a case that this health center cannot handle? Now look at road networks and then traffic management. So you see where surveyors will now come in terms of traffic management. The surveyors should be able to tell you the best routes, alternative routes, in case an ambulance needs to evacuate somebody from a primary health, from a health center,
right?
You know, to, for instance, the teaching hospital. What is the best route?
So the surveyors need to explain that.
There's traffic jam, yes.
Right. Okay, so it appears multiple roles. It appears the surveyor is always needed in virtually all fields right now. Perhaps maybe the only other area that they might not be so that they can be extended to, maybe might be to minister now in the church, right?
funny enough, In church planting, surveyors play a very key role.
You mean
very
it?
Key role, yes.
You mean it?
Because if you truly want to fulfill the scriptures that says, you know, go into the world and multiply, be my disciples from Samaria to Judea and to the uttermost parts of the earth. You need to know where you are. You need to know where your Jerusalem is.
Okay.
Which is your location before you now.
Lagos Traffic Radio, 96.1 FM. I'm speaking with Surveyor Agwu Roberts Ogonna. He is the Publicity Secretary, Association of Private Practicing Surveyors of Nigeria, APPSN, Lagos State Branch. And I also have with me in the studio Surveyor Abimbola Komolafe, who is the Publicity Secretary of the Nigerian Institution of Surveyors. So if you want to join the conversation too, let's see if we can expand the scope beyond the studios right now to have your input as well. 080-99-120-777. You've heard from them, the relevance of surveyors in today's world, and they appear to be everywhere, you know. They seem to be sought after. Their services will be needed to improve situations. But if there are some other areas you feel they've not mentioned, you can bring that on board. Let's hear from you, and let's take that to the next level. That's a message here. It says, good morning, Traffic Radio, and greetings to your guests. Is it the work of surveyors to update the Google map in Nigeria? That's Adebayo sending that one in. So is it surveyors that do that? Are you the ones that update Google map?
Yes. Google is a map application, and then for every form of update, a surveyor plays a key role in doing that.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay, so Adebayo, it means you are very correct. Very, very straight to the point. So he's answered you directly. Surveyors play a pivotal role in updating the map that is used by talking about Google. Let's talk about technology now. Technology and surveying. You talk about the geographic information system, right? Are you saying that surveyors are the ones that come up with this kind of information? Surveyor AgriRobots?
In terms of,
geographic information system now. When we talk about GIS.
Yes.
Is it surveyors that come up with that system as well?
Yes. GIS is a tool that surveyors make use of in delivering their services.
Okay.
So, it's a tool.
So it's always very relevant. That you guys know. So in terms of advancement of the profession now, what role has technology played?
Okay, so technology has played a very vital role in the advancement of the profession. For instance, in Ghana, the days for you to carry out mapping of any particular area, you have to make use of the archaic equipment we use, like the Gunter's chain, which is a form of tape that is used in linear measurements. And you need to employ somebody to even carry the tape. Yes, because it's quite bulky and all that. But now technology has made things so difficult that with devices as small as a smartphone, you can get measurements of locations. And then at the click of a button, you can run analysis that would have ordinarily taken you weeks to run.
All right, then, Lagos Traffic Radio. Hello there, good morning. Okay, I guess we lost that. 0809912077 and 0915387-7127. All right, so we are exploring the relevance of surveyors in today's world. And you've heard from Surveyor Agwu.
Hello.
Roberts. Hello there, good morning.
Good morning. I've been listening to your analysis. I'm on with Traffic Radio, right?
Yes, what's your name?
My name is Kolawole Oluwemimo. I'm also a surveyor by profession, and
great.
I'm really, really impressed with the analysis that your guests have put through.
Right.
And I want to reiterate that in every aspect of life, surveying is very, very essential. And if you look at countries like Canada, the United States of America, Australia, they have done very well in that aspect, and that is why you see things are in order in those places. But unfortunately, in our climate, surveying is being a very, very underrated profession.
Why do you say that?
I say that because majority of engineers actually appreciate surveying. They think they can do what surveyors will do, but they cannot. And that is precision. Surveyors are the best precision measurement makers in any field.
Right.
Yes, and like your analysts have said, every aspect of nationhood, every aspect of development requires surveying, whether you like it or not.
How many years have you been in the profession, Surveyor Wemimo?
I've been in this profession for over 10 years, and I work in the oil and gas industry. And you know that all your pipeline routes are designed by surveyors.
Obviously. So
all your pipeline routes, all your jackets, all your platforms, your seismic surveying, all the location where you will locate the well, they are determined by surveyors.
Right.
And that's how it goes in every field, especially in extractive industry.
And this is rare technical skill, so to say. So it means we have very, very few of you that are in this particular area. So what would you say to Nigeria, if we are to really appreciate the work of surveyors more, what would be your recommendation?
Come again, please.
I said, if we are to appreciate the works of surveyors more in this country, what would be your recommendation?
I think it has to, legislation is very key.
Okay.
Legislation is very important. Even when you look at cadastral surveying, how many landowners have surveys? That is where legislation comes in. How many construction companies employ registered surveyors rather than training quacks to do what surveyors should be doing?
Right. Okay.
So legislation is key. Legislation is very key. And then, of course, we know that many things are not going right in our time. Many, many things are not going right. People are not doing the right things that they should be doing. And that is why we have a lot of engineering misappropriations.
All right. Okay, then. It's nice to hear from you.
In your road constructions, you have a lot of misappropriation in terms of design, in terms of structures, and all that. So it cuts across a lot of... It's not something we'll just sit down and decide in a day or on a phone call.
That's right. Okay, let me appreciate you. Thank you so much, Tavio.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I've been listening to your analysis, and I really enjoyed your inputs and your contribution.
Thank you. I really appreciate you. Thank you, too. All right, so that's somebody who's very much involved. He's a surveyor like you, and we'll try to see if you can answer that question or why the built environment or perhaps the people that are in that particular sector. We have so many professionals. Sometimes they appear to... they want to undermine the surveyor's role. But I have some messages here. This one says, good morning, sir. I am Tokbe from Isheri. Says, what role does surveyors play in space astronomy? Surveyor Agrobos, can you answer that one?
Yes, very well. Okay, so even in space, the issue of location is also required. Or the question of location needs to be answered.
Okay.
Yes. So even your space platforms and all that, you need to know. For instance, how do you determine the distance that your space shuttle will travel?
Okay. So surveyors will be needed there too.
Yes, surveyors are needed there. So there's an aspect of surveying that is called that space technology is required. So even in Nigeria, we used to have a regional center for aerospace.
That's right.
Yes.
Surveyor Abimbola, there's a question here. It says, do miners need the service of surveyors as well? Ibrahim is sending that one in from Jabba Tech.
Yeah, definitely. When, as we rightly mentioned, that what exactly is where? And when I mentioned what exactly is where, there was a part that I mentioned near, inside, and under the hard surface.
Yeah.
So there's what we call mining survey. And mining survey has a coordination act which we follow. So for all miners, there is definitely a surveyor there. So they as Surveyor Agu rightly said, they are the one that will tell you what exactly is here at a particular point in time.
Let's begin to drive this home this morning. So somebody is listening to you, and the son or the daughter has just gotten an admission to read surveying, and the parents are grumbling. So what will you say to that kind of a parent, Surveyor Robert?
Okay, well, for somebody like me, I also stumbled into surveying. I didn't set out having an issue to study surveying or to become a surveyor. You know, so the part of what we are doing now is to go to the secondary schools to begin to create that awareness so that we don't keep having accidental surveyors, but we have people who make up their minds from the secondary schools to study surveying.
So in secondary school, would the student be reading art or would it be...
No, sciences.
It has to be in the sciences,
yes, because you must have physics, mathematics, and then, of course, the O-level requirements, physics, chemistry, biology,
geography.
All right.
Yes. So geography is also an option for you.
All that is needed. How can I identify a real, true, certified surveyor?
Okay. Identifying a surveyor is simple. When you're interacting with one, especially for your private surveys, confirm that he is duly registered with the Surveyors Council of Nigeria. Ask him for his SOCON registration number.
Okay.
And then insist on meeting with him in his office. And then when you get to his office, here are the simple things to look out for. His certificate of registration with SOCON must be boldly displayed in his office. his CAC certification, his certificate of a company enlistment, or company registration with the CAC must be displayed in his office.
All right.
And then from the comfort of your home, you could just check on Google and type "surveyors near me," and then confirm that his name is on that list.
All right, we'll leave it to that for now. Let's go because of time for constraints now. Surveyor Abimbola, Komolafe, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much.
All right, and to Surveyor Agwu Robert, nice having you in the building too. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
All right, so we'll be able to explore the relevance of surveying in today's world. And like you heard, they appear to be everywhere. So in all professions, at least a tinge of surveying is always required. And that's why we say always implore the services of surveyors if you have to carry out any of those activities for development. We have to go. The program has been produced by Mike James. I say a big thank you to our social media team, Okwemi Shodunke and Remy Aloko. Tayo Akonle is our executive producer. My name is Victor Oteri. Have a splendid weekend.